Here's how to use absolute position inside of Figma like an absolute pro. So this first example, I've got a card and it's got an image, some text, and I want to add a timecode. But if I drag it into the card, you can see because this is an auto layout frame, everything in this frame is obeying these rules. So they're stacked vertically with a gap between them, and I just can't get the timecode in the right position. What I can do is I can press this button over here. This is the absolute position button. And then once I've pressed that, this element doesn't follow the auto layout flow, so I can put it absolutely anywhere I want. So I'm just gonna put it right there. In this next example, we can see I've got a component and I've used that in a few different places. And I wanna put this squiggle in to make some of these stand out a bit more. And again, I can't put it exactly where I want because it's obeying the flow of auto layout in this component. So what I can do is I can grab that scribble element, set it to absolute position, and then I can put it anywhere I want. So let's put it right here, maybe recolor it to be red. And then super quickly, I'm just going to turn it into a component property so that I can turn it off for the ones where it doesn't fit. Last example is with notifications. So I can't put the notification exactly where I want it. I want it to sit here on the corner, but I can't do that because it just sits inside of this auto layout frame. So if I put it inside of my auto layout frame, hit this absolute position icon, a plus in a frame, and you can see the frame over here in the layers panel. So that tells you when items have absolute position. And then I can put it exactly where I want. And a cool thing here, if I type in a number, you can see the frame that this is in doesn't obey it, but I can give this frame an auto layout property and I can set that to have a padding 12. So even though this is an absolutely positioned element, it itself can have auto layout, which means that we can set the number and it obeys it automatically. And if I just constrain that to the right and at the top, now you can see when I type in a number, it behaves as we want. It sticks to that right and that top area, but it stretches out to fill what we need. So those are three super quick examples. I've left a link to this file in the description if you want to try it out. Thank you so much for watching.